Hello, friends. Just getting the last little technical deals figured out here, but it's lovely to be seen, I suppose, not see you, on this sunny Saturday morning in Seattle. We're going to be doing some dancing as usual here in just a moment, but if you want to get pre-gamed on the music a little bit, they're down the doodly-doo as ever. We're doing some Count Basie today. I didn't just forget to put the name of the thing on the stream title. The name of the song is actually No Name by Count Basie. So he chose that, not me. And then we're going to be doing a warm-up to Jonathan Doyle because Jonathan Doyle. That's really the reasoning. But we're going to give folks a couple more seconds to tune in here while I make sure that everything is going swimmingly. I see movement on my monitor. We're trying a little bit different on the music today because my laptop decided to give up the ghost, so we're doing music for my phone. So let me know if you can't hear something or if things need to change a little bit. That should be okay. And yeah, let's get the warm-up queued up here and we'll just get started. My warm-up is, like I said, by Jonathan Doyle. There's one album of Jonathan Doyle's, which is this from, that's available on Spotify. But for all the rest of his stuff, you should go to the link down below on Bandcamp there, and even for this album, because he gets a much bigger cut of the proceeds if we take it from Bandcamp than if we do it from Spotify or Apple Music or whatever. So follow that Bandcamp link, go support some Pacific Northwest musicians that do great things for us in the before times and are continuing to make music now so they can keep doing that and not have to do other more boring pursuits. So this is I've Never Been to New York by the Jonathan Doyle Quintet. Find yourself some elbow room, make sure you can move around a little bit. And we're gonna start with a nice, easy, relaxed feeling warm-up, but make sure you're engaging your core, keeping yourself in a dance posture, just because the music's a little easy. Don't let yourself avoid getting warmed up, because there's a purpose for this. So here we go. Thank you. New friends in the room. Welcome. Hopefully you got a little bit of that warm up. If not, keep your body moving here while I chat for a second. Today's song is going to be by Count Basie. This is a song from the 1950s by Count Basie. So it's kind of right in that middle period between Old Testament Basie and New Testament Basie. And you're going to feel, I think, in this song, it's not quite like a lot of the Count Basie stuff you might know if you're really into the old stuff, because it's not just that quarter note all the time, the chunk, 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 chunk. And it's also not the New Testament stuff in that it doesn't do the kind of Sinatra at the Sands, like super dynamic changes and big stretchy melody bits. It's kind of this nice in-between bit. For me, this song feels kind of like Boogie Forwards. It has that 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 feeling, like a stroll, which is kind of how popular dances of the time were. They were kind of strolls. So I'm going to try and have us keep that kind of groove feeling that we had on that last warm-up song, cut through the rest of this. Let's listen to a little bit of No Name by Count Basie here. That's about half of what we're going to get through. But it's got that kind of light floating along feeling, like you're kind of inner tubing down a river in the summer or walking around in a nice outfit getting seen. So we're going to start off with something pretty chill, but I want to put some attitude into it. So take all the time you can to fill out this movement. We're going to do it a few times, so you'll have lots of chances to do it. This is inspired by a combo that Josh Welter choreographed a while ago. If you don't know who that is, he's a really awesome jazz dancer who is mostly retired from swing dance stuff to like raise a kid and things, do a real job. But we're going to start off with a little bit of chugs. So we're just going to go right, left, right, left. So if you do that, we're going to get closer to the floor. So you go, ba-do, ba-do. So 5, 6, 7, ba-do, ba-do. We're starting a little bit before the one, right? We're going and 8 and 1. So 5, 6, 7, ba-do, ba-do. From here, we're going to do one boogie back. If you want to do the kickball change, you're welcome to. For me, I'm just doing the ball change part. So I'm going clap, ball change as I move back. So we have 5, 6, 7, and 8, and 1, 2, and 3. A 5, 6, 7, and 8, and 1, 2, and 3. 5, 6, 7, and 8, and 1, 2, and 3. Now we're going to lift up our right leg by transferring our weight to our left. Scuff that heel on the floor. 4, 5, doing that boogie forward I talked about. 6, 7. So we have 5, 6, 7, and 8, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5, 6, 7, and 8, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Cool. And for those of you that are going to practice this after the class, when you go to this song, you're going to find that the opening beat is never right exactly where you expect it to be until you've listened to it once, or maybe more than once. So let's listen to that together again. And one thing I want to point out right away is that the intro, the opening sound, hits at a different beat than once you hit the melody. So let's listen for that. So at the beginning, when it's doing that 4/8 of intro, you'll hear a sound before count one. So it's got a pickup note a little bit to it, like this. Eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three. So the honk is on the one, but you got that little bit beforehand. As we get into the melody, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three. So this one actually starts late. When you're practicing on your own, it's really important to know that, because when you're trying to count, if you start when the music starts and you hear sound, you're going to be a little bit off. So we're actually going to start our dancing in the silence before that happens. So remember, on the melody, it starts on count two, and we're starting on the and before eight. So it'll go, and eight, and one, two. And on that boogie back clap, that's where you're first going to hear sound in the music. So let's just try that here. I'll count you in, we'll listen to the intro, and just get into that first bit. I think the trickiest part of this whole routine is figuring out that timing. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Because it's a little tricky, I gave us four times through this pattern with a little bit at the end to process. So we're going to go badu badu shakadu ah ooh ah ooh. Then we're going to do a little lock turn. So we went 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. So and 8 and 1, 2 and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. So let's listen to that with the music, just that bit. I'm not 100% convinced, but I can't take more time on that. So if you feel like it feels yummier to go a little slower on that 8-1 and just go 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, and give yourself a little time to get around. Just play with that. I think I like it more. I'm not sure. But let's do that one more time with the music, and then we'll add up. Yeah, I think I like it on a 1, because that's where the notes hit. So let's do that a little bit later. So we'll go 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, a 1, So we'll wait a little bit longer until the horns are going, and we'll follow them on that lock turn. So we went ba boop ba boop ah ah boop da, and then it does the same thing again. It goes wah wah. So we're going to take a little bit of a fishtail here. Just like a light fishtail, nothing huge. Right, left. So I'm basically just walking, but I'm pushing my feet into the floor like a cat pushing into a stack of laundry. So I toe through heel, really working my foot into the floor. And while I do that, I'm aiming my butt to the right and then to the left. So I go wah, 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 wah. But you can practice walking that around a little bit. It's somewhere between an applejack and a fishtail. To me, I think the details of the physicality is kind of more applejack, but the emotion I'm trying to convey is more fishtail. So make it a really sassy, slow applejack if you're going to feel that way. So you have 5, 6, 7, and 8, and 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, a 1, ba, So a little bit of sass in there. And then you have one more beat to just reset your feet. So it goes, and I'm just dropping my left heel down to get ready to do the same thing again, facing the opposite direction. So we'll just go, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, and we're gonna do that 4 times in a row, and it's gonna be perfect the first try, right? So 4 times in a row, starting from the top, I'll count you out. All right. So we're going to practice that a couple more times because this one I think will take some starting to hear the music and how the moves relate to it before it feels second nature for folks. But if you have any questions about it, feel free to type them up in the comments over there. And I'll get back to those really quick because I know it is a little bit tricky timing-wise. In most of our choreography so far, I've kept it really elementary. We're often following the melody or following something obvious in the rhythm. And now what we're doing is this melody that Basie's put together for us has a bunch of really cool gaps in it. So we're playing with going along with what the horns are doing, but also doing our own thing sometimes in those silences between the bits. And that can be awesome for choreography, or it can be a terrible mistake. So you can decide which one I have done. But when you're choreographing your own stuff, those little gaps where no horns are playing is sometimes a great place to put your own little dense rhythms, because your audience can go, oh, you did a thing. And if it's at the same time as the music, sometimes they don't even see how brilliant you're being. Although sometimes they can just be like, cool, you're with music. I dig that. That's awesome. Let's try that again. One more time. Again, if you have questions, this is a good time to type them up. When you're doing this one, on that last time, so we did that prep after our fishtail applejack hybrid move, that last one, we're going to make it just one more rotation of the hips. So most of the times that we're going through there, we've gone, we're kind of resetting forward for our badoopadoos. On the last one, we're actually going to let our hips rotate during that. So we'll go, boo-wah. Then we're going to stay on that left foot. We'll get two more hip twists out of it. So that was two more hip twists and we end up on our left foot at the end. Let's go from the top with music and then we'll dig into our bridge section. So the reason we're getting on that left foot and we're doing those hip twists is we're going right into a fall off the log from here with the right foot. So this is the first fall off the log most people learn. Shouldn't be too wonky, but let's just talk about it real quick in case we have new folks on here. A fall off the log, for our purposes today, is going to be hopping onto your left foot letting your right foot trail behind. Sometimes folks think about that as a kick to the right, but it's not a forceful thing. It's more like I'm leaving my foot behind as my body moves toward the left. So there's that kick, another step behind, to the side, and in front. So you do a little three-step grapevine. And that goes 8, 1, 2, 3. One thing that's really easy to forget is the rhythm on count 8 to actually do something. A lot of times fall off the logs look a little lame because people go 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And it's not about that foot. It feels like it wants to be, but it's actually about the one that's landing on the ground. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So whether you're hopping onto it all the way like that or just clicking your heel down, we want to have some rhythm underneath you for that fall off the log. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's a fall. It's not like a kick off the log. It's a fall off the log. So we're going to do one side of that only. We've got four counts. Student, boo-up, boo-up, boo. 8, 1, 2, 3. So it flows right into it from that last bit. From there, we're going to do not another fall off the log, but it still moves that you know. We're going to do a start up like we're going to. We do a little kick, but then a triple step. Student, 8, 1, 2, 3, kick. This one's gonna be just a little kick underneath me, like I'm doing a kickball change. I'm gonna go behind, side, front again. So it's kind of like a fall off the log. I still have a kick, I still have a behind, side, and a front. But our rhythm is kick, triple step. Kick, triple step. Let's try it a couple times. It goes kick, triple step, and the 5, 6, 7, and the kick, triple step, and the 5, 6, 7, the kick, triple step. And one more time, and the kick, triple step. So far in this phrase, we did our boop, bop, boop, 8, 1, 2, 3. This is just a fall off the log. We do one kick, triple step. So we're kind of going over to the left, and then a little downstage and to the right. So let's just do that fall off the log into the kick, triple step. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, kick, triple step. And that feels like it leaves me hanging, so I'm gonna take one more step forward. On to my right. So it goes, fall off the log, kick, triple step, step. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Fall off the log, kick, triple step, step. Once more with feelings. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Fall off the log, kick, triple step, step. For me, I feel like a fall off the log wants to be pretty big, and then the kick triple step step, I'm keeping it pretty compact. Let me get a little texture in there that way. Also, when I'm doing something that's changing direction pretty quickly, the closer I am to myself, the faster I can move that way. So it just gives me a little extra power. We'll say that one more time from the fall off the log. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Fall off the log, kick triple step step. Now we're going to put your left foot where your right foot is. So I'm just putting it on the ground and popping my right foot forward. If I'm profile to you, that looks like this. So I'm kind of sitting onto my left foot. So I went, fall off the log, kick, triple step, step, switch. So let's do that all together. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Fall off the log, kick, triple step, step, switch. If you want numbers, it's like this. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. And I really want to be back on that left foot because this is going to start Susie Q's. So we went 7, 8. On one, I'm going to cross into the first intersecting shape of my Susie Q's. So my right foot's in front. My weight's on the heel of my right foot, and I open up that left leg. I rotate out from my hip socket to the side, and then I cross over. And that's the end of our Susie Q's, but we have a little moment of them in here. So we went, fall off the log, kick, triple step, step, switch, Susie Q. With the fan. Let's do it all together. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. We're not going to do anything on four, and then we're going to kind of stutter. Ba-do, ba-do, ba-do. So we went 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left, right, left, right, left, right. So let's go from the fossil log through the end of that. 5, 6, 7. Fall off the log. Oh, I messed up. Let's start again. 5, 6, 7. Fall off the log. Kick, trip, step, step, switch. Susie Q. Buddy, buddy, buddy. And once it counts, for those of you that are numbers minded, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. So we're going to go from the top with music here in a second. I'll give you a chance to type up any questions you may or may not have. When you're going from the transition between the phrases, it's okay if that last Applejack fishtail thing gets a little bit sloppy as you're like, oh shoot, get to the fall off the log. But eventually, I want to use that move, the rotation of that move, to power into my fall off the log. So as you're running this a few times, try and get the brain space available to look for that transition from just doing the twist, twist, stop, do it at fall off the log, to using the rotation of your hips to get into that first kick of the fall off the log. If it's not there right now, I still love you, don't worry. From the top, with music, all the way through. Assuming that was a weird transition, it comes up pretty quick if you're not ready for it. I am going to plow us ahead a little bit further so we can get more content in our practice runs for this phrase, just to make sure we stay on schedule. But if you have questions specifically about how to do something, definitely send them over the messages and I will get to those individually. But for now, we're going to plow ahead and then we'll come back and review that a million times. So we're going to do a fall off the log again. We're going to do it on the other side. So we have... fall off the log, kick, triple step, step, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. So at the end of that 7, I should be on my right foot. We've got our fall off the log on the left side. Fall off the log. And actually, everyone take a second, try a couple fall off the logs on the left side, and make sure you still have that percussion under your standing leg. Because lots of folks are good at this side, dropping onto that left heel. When we switch it around, I find that most people get a little lazy, it turns into a little flaily kick. And we want this to really be a fall off the log. So let yourself move down the side of that ramp there. So try that a couple times on your own, and we'll jump together here. And then as you're doing that, try and think about where the beat is again. So every beat has at least something going on with that pulse. You're not gonna die on the odd numbers or die on the even numbers. You got something going on every beat. Try that a couple times. Type of questions if you got them. And this is going to be a very similar feeling for a moment. So we have that fall off the log, kick, just like before. But then we're going to do another one of those switches. So we have fall off the log, kick, switch. So it's like I'm trying not to fall off a spinning log, right? I'm letting that backward body posture here happen. It's like a cakewalk kind of feeling. So we have 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna kind of bicycle this left leg to get it underneath me for a ball change. So it's gonna sound the same if you're like just saying the words. It goes fall off the log, kick, switch, ball change. But the weight changes are a little bit different from the first time. So I'll try that left side again over here. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, kick, switch, ball change. I'll try and do it without the retard onto this time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And I really pull in my core to get that N6 down in time. If you can't switch your angle of your body, it's going to be really hard to get to the ground in time for that. So let's try that again.
Checking it out.
I'm hurting Jonathan's brain. That's great. Just like old times. So let's go from that left side. We go 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Kick, kick. Ball change. One more time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Kick, kick. Ball change. I hope you can see that I'm going in here as I'm kind of in the air. I'm really focusing on getting into a little bit of a ball. And then we're actually going to shrink that down even lower in a second. So we're on our way down to a really low shape. So you can let that get a little high on that first kick. 8, 1, 2, 3, kick, kick, ball change. And that lift will make a good contrast when we drop to the floor here in a second. Let's go from the first fall off the log. So that was fall off the log, kick, triple step, step, and Susie Q. Buddy, 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 fall off the log, kick, kick, ball change. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. Fall off the log, kick, triple step, step. 8, 1, 2, 3. A 5, a 6, a 7. Fall off the log, kick, kick, ball change. Awesome. So we're going to go kick, kick, ball change, step. We're continuing that same sounding rhythm, even though our weight changes are different than last time. So fall off the log, kick, kick, ball change, step. And then we're going to do our classic Shorty George here. And then we'll mess it up in a second. So we just went kick, kick, ball, change, step under our left foot. We're going to kick, ball, change again to the side with our right foot. So kick, ball, change. If you haven't done Shorty George's before, I'm going to give you a version that you should do all of today. Like, just do this beginner version until you have time to really focus on the technique of the move. And that's kick, ball, change. And then I'm going to take about half of the length of my foot steps across the floor. So I'm kind of taking the instep of my foot, sticking it in the arch of my other foot, and creeping forward. And you kind of have to go to the bathroom, and I'm taking small steps. See, about half a step every time. And I'm going to keep those parallel, so they're going straight ahead of me. So that would look like this. Kick, ball, step, 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 step. The actual move Shorty George is going to have a lot more waiver to it, but there's a couple of ways to do it that don't hurt your knees, and there are a lot of ways to do it that do hurt your knees. I have a video up online already breaking that down in slow motion for you, and it's up there for free. So go look up the Shim Sham tutorial that I put up, and I break down Shorty George's in excruciating detail. But for now, if you don't know them already, just kick, ball, step, 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 like so. For those of you that have done Shorty George's, we're going to go ahead and let those get really low, because we gotta have some contrast. So we went fall off the log, kick, triple step, step, switch, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, kick, kick, ball change, step, kick, ball, step, 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 step. And we're gonna finish that circle coming around. I would love for this to kind of merry-go-round horse as we go, so we'll get lower and then taller again. And the counts on that are 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7. So you have 3 on the quarter notes and then 2 half notes. 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7. So let's do the whole fall off the log phrase. Starting on the right kick over here, the left foot's landing. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7. And you've probably seen it because you're all brilliant and astute people, but I forgot to tell you, we're turning in between 3 and 5. So we're kind of coming around, and then you're going to pivot to face forward right while you're balanced on that 3 foot. That's why we have that pause in there. So 8 and 1, 2, 3, whoop, 5, 7. Cool. Checking for your comments and questions. Looking good. Awesome. So let's go back a little bit further. We're going to do the last iteration of our badoop, badoop, shakadoo from the beginning, and then go into this fall off the log section just to make sure we have that seamless transition. So this one's facing the back. So if you need to glance over your shoulder to get the timing here with me, you're welcome to. But otherwise, just own it. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, fall off the log, kick, triple step, step, switch, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, fall off the log, kick, kick, ball change, step, kick, ball change, step, 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 step. And we're going to go with the whole thing, because I think we're moving about the speed of the song anyway, so we may as well get practice on the whole thing. Basie. There's so much space to play in his music. Cool. Now that I've done two runs in a row, I'm assuming everyone would like a drink of water and someone might have a question. So take a second, have a sip, type that up if you got it. We are 3/4 of the way through our choreography. And like I said, I think the hardest part of this piece is finding the timing on that opening because I didn't put it right where he feeds it to you. You have to actually know the counts yourself. So when you're practicing this on your own throughout the week, definitely take time to okay, cool. Can I sit here and count it and know when I'm supposed to start? And my phone thought I was trying to talk to Google. Gotta love the new devices. All right, cool. Looks like we are doing all right then. So the next part gets a little bit bigger motions, and it will seem a little bit more tricky, but we pre-gamed for this in a previous week. So we've done these moves before, and it's actually a little bit less rhythmically dense, so I think it's easier. So don't let the fact that we're going to rotate daunt you. All right, so we just finished the last Shorty George. We're gonna go Badum. So I'm just throwing myself out onto my heels in kind of a V-slide. And this time we're gonna follow the music. So it's the same melody as the first times when we went on and eight and one, but we're gonna wait all the way till that and two. So that sounds like this. You hear that, ba-da, it's got a silent little boom, ba-da. That beat beforehand, for me, it's really tempting to do something, fight the urge. So it goes 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, and 2. And we're gonna throw ourselves up on and two, throw ourselves up. Cool, hopefully that makes sense. If I'm speaking nonsense and you're like, Ben, what are you talking about? I'm gonna try and clarify by adding the rest of the move, but feel free to write that up too. So we're gonna do a rock step, step, turn, land. So really simple rhythm. It's just boom, 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 boom. So it went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. So This is the same turn we've done in the past. So one and two, three, four, five, seven. Let's stay on the right. It's even easier. We're going to go one and two, rock, step. Step and turn at the same time. So I'm turning my torso, keeping my shoulders level so I'm not spilling water out of that bowl. And I'm bringing my left knee in to get me around. This should work even if you're on a pretty sticky floor because you're powering it from a strong place. But a couple of tips for you. One, if your floor is super sticky, just kind of get through it. Like, walk and don't hit your knee. Another thing is if you're trying to do a turn and you're on a sticky floor, make sure your knees are strongly supported from below so that you're not locked up, because that puts a lot of stress on the knee. If you're down here, it moves some of that stress between the different joints. So stay super low on the turn if your floor is stickier. And, you know, you can also just bookmark that for later and practice it on a better floor in a future time. So we had a 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Let's just do that a few times. 5, 6. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Another thing that really helps with turns, and if you practice classical dance, you already know, or whatever other dance, studio dances, they teach this stuff. And swing dance, we're like, I don't know, push a partner around. But if I go from wide to small, I'm going from flat to round, it makes me spin. So what I'm doing is I'm bringing my shape in on my left side here, and that's helping me get around at the same time as this is helping me get around. And to boot, I had that rock step to prep, right? So I can bring myself to the left during that rock step and release to the right with my upper body as I'm stepping down onto my right foot. So let's try that all together one more time. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Nice. I know a couple of you have ballet training. Try not to be too tall on this one. You're going to feel like, ooh, I get to do the thing that I know. Try and keep it jazzy. If you're working on it now and you're like, I need to stay tall first just to get through the choreo, great. Go back afterward and try and be like, can I make a swing dancey shape out of this and modify it a little bit? Because it's really tempting to go, ooh, I have muscle memory here, and bring those hips in underneath and not keep those hamstrings as active as we want them to be. So check yourself before you wreck yourself. That's all I'm saying. We just did a big crazy. We're just going to do two mambo steps next. They're syncopated, but it's just mambo steps, so it's nice and easy. So we went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 1, 3, 5, 7. The difference between a normal mambo step and these ones is we're going to go boom, ba-doom, boom, ba-doom, instead of just cha, 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 because of what the music's doing. So let's listen for that real quick, see if it makes sense to everybody. So we're following that ba-do-dot, ba-do-dot. So ball change step, a one and, a five and. So we've got and two, three, four, five, seven, ball change step. Let's just try that. Let's try it all together. Starting with that, 8, 1, and 2. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, and 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, ba-do-da, ba-do-da. Seems easy, right? Let's do it one more time just to prove it. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, and 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, ba-do-da, ba-do-da. Tip, if you're having trouble getting that first ball change step in there in time, you're probably too tall on your turn. So if you're too tall on your turn, at least drop down for the landing. Because if I'm up here, it's really hard for me to get to the floor in time. So get low, get low, get low. Cool. Checking the questions. You're all lovely. We're going to do kind of the same thing again. Instead of having it be up for our and two, we're going to go low, just for some change of pace. And we're going to change the direction of our facing a little bit. So on this last ba-do-da, 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 I'm going to take myself to the corner here a little bit. And I have an optional bit that we might put in here for those that want to, but I'm not sure if I like it yet. So for now, we're just going to plan on holding there until and two, three, four, five. I'm doing kind of the same situation, but at a different angle. So we went ba-do-wop, ba-do-wop, six, seven, eight, one, and two is going to be just a normal ball change, three, four. And then we're going to take that turn again, but we're already facing this wall, kind of. So we're not going to have as much distance to cover if you wanted to face forward. So we're going to take that extra time and change the shape a little bit. As you come around, I'm going to back away side on to my audience instead of being facing my audience. So this part goes, and two, three, four, five, seven. I'm kind of sitting back onto my left cheek here as I come out of that turn. So as I'm coming around, I'm going, let's go this way. And I'm doing that by powering from my right foot. So I'm pushing my right foot as I spin. I compress and charge. Play with the lines. This looks different on everybody. I have a lot of leg, so it's hard for me to find a line that I like on a shape like this where I'm side on the audience. Because I can either be here and kind of go for that deeper line, or I can go for straight legs. Everyone's got a different body, so as you're playing with this, figure out the line you like. What I do want is to be side onto my audience and going back onto that left foot here. You can decide how fast your body follows that. But. So our first one went, and two, three, four, five, seven, eight, ba-do-da, ba-do-da. And two, three, four, five, seven, eight. We're going to come out of it sideways. Let's try that all together. Five, six, five, six, seven, eight, one, and two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, and two, three, five, and six, seven, eight, one, and two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Once more with feeling. Five, six, five, six, seven, eight, one, and two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Oh, shh, don't tell anyone, I just messed up. Five, six, five, six, seven, eight, one, and two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, and two, three, five, and six, seven, eight, one, and two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. There we go.
About the hard part, I just forgot the mambo steps. So there's a couple options here, but let's try it with music once through this part and just see how much of a gap we have there, because I might want to fill it with a couple hops. We'll see. Let's put the hops in there. So all we're gonna do is two little hops after this first. Ba-do-ba, hop, hop. So we're gonna hop toward our corner a little bit, and a little bunny hops. Nothing fancy, just adding a little bit of something to fill that space. I will show you, feel free to dance along if you want to do it. Just to get more practice with the music, that's always good.
So it's nothing fancy, it just gives you a little moment to play with your audience some, so just ooh, ooh, a little chug forward, style it however you want. If you want to do two runs instead of two hops, more power to you. I just like to have something there to fill that space, I think, instead of waiting for four counts. If you can handle, like you have the self-control and the presence to be able to just hold for those counts and make it look awesome, that's great too. But I want to get into the last little bit of our thing. Let's try that one more time, and then we have eight counts left, and we have made it. So let's try that.
Five, six, seven, eight, one.
Oh. Lies, wrong part of the song. Don't tell anybody. Here we go.
Five, six, seven, eight, one.
the same as that we've done in the past, where we're going to end up facing side onto our audience and our end pose here, but it was on the last one. What I'd like you to do, I'm going to give you one option that I've choreographed, and I would love for you to play with the choices here so you can create your own. I would love to fake the audience out. So I would like to act like I'm doing one thing and then end up just being like, what's up? And hitting that pose. So what we're going to do in the OG choreo here is turn the other way partially and then go, working this way actually. So after we finished our here and we slid back, I'm going to go this way and then bring it back around. So I wind myself up like a top and then I let that unwind to bring me the other direction. If you want to do other moves, you can be like, you can do that simple. But what I would like for you to do is do something that fakes out your audience and then comes back around. So again, what I'm doing looks like this. And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But I'm just going to wind myself up and unwind. But I would love to see what you all come up with when you send me those videos this week. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. So let's go through that from the first ba-do-da-do, where we do the big star shape on and two, and see if we can make it all the way to the end. If you have a cool idea, I want to see it. So hopefully you can hear how there's sort of a fake out and then the final punch there. That's what we're going for. Abada, abada. Cool. Let's try it from the top with music, because I think you've all got this. I haven't seen anyone make mistakes because it's YouTube and I can't see you, but also because you're probably awesome. Of course you're awesome. So, change the window back. Sorry, team. Here we go. From the top. John, you're so honest. I appreciate you. He says he's made a lot of mistakes, but I think that's probably true for everyone. I'm just giving you the benefit of the doubt here. If I haven't seen them, they're not real, right? That's how science works. So we're going to do this one more time here in a second. I'm going to give you a second to get water if you want to recall in your audience from the other room, to write up your questions if you got those for me. Breathe a little bit. Yeah. If you have a particular part where you have a transition that's just not clicking in your brain, take this moment to run through that a couple of times. Just like, okay, it's this move into that move. It's this move into that move. Like actually walk through the steps in your body some. Because your brain will fart, but your body will be solid. So give yourself a little bit there. Try it out. Awesome. All right, let's dance it. From the top. Perfection, of course. Six, seven.
Awesome. Cool. And if you are somebody who has a partner available and can do some actual Lindy Hop, this tune is awesome to social dance to. It's like the perfect tempo, got that solid rhythm section, fun little hits to play with. They repeat just often enough to still be exciting, but also to give you a chance to hit them. So check out No Name, Count Basie, link in the doodly-doo, and dance to it for me. And eventually we'll dance to it together. So, you know, brain check on that, but I would love to ask you all to dance. The other thing is if you weren't here for the warm-up, or if you were and you forgot, down here in the doodly-doo is a link to Jonathan Doyle on Bandcamp. I'm sure you've heard me say it before, but Bandcamp gives 85% of their money they get from the CDs to the artists, which is huge compared to other platforms. So if you're going to pick up music from musicians who are still alive, definitely get it there because they get a much better deal on that than other places. They also do a First Friday free thing. So look up on their website and make sure you know exactly the date to pick up your music. If you wait until the appropriate date for each month. During COVID, Bandcamp is donating all of the proceeds one day a month to those artists. So go check out Bandcamp. The link's down there in the bio for Jonathan's particular page, but you can navigate from there to the main page. And like put on your calendar every month to pick up music on that day of the month. And also, if you're looking for what music to pick up, you can flip through all these videos. You know, I've got at least one album on every video, I think, that you can grab that's going to support a current musician who's still making music. We posted on the Syncopation page a little while ago, the Syncopation Foundation Facebook page. Caleb Elwert, one of our dancers, went and just made a spreadsheet of a bunch of different artists that have music up on there, and the links to go get it, so you don't have to do any searching. You can just be like, I want to try something new. Click that. So maybe schedule out your next few months of supporting artists while they can't do actual live shows and things, so we have good swing music to come back to at the end of all this. Thanks for hanging out, everybody. If you would like to do a technique class with us, we're doing that on Wednesday evenings. That's through our Patreon for those that are $15 or more. Or if you can't make it to that time, it's not exactly the highest quality video because I'm videotaping a Zoom class. But I have video of myself that I'm taking in those classes to send to people who are in the wrong time zone for that or whatever. So you can still join us even though it's a Zoom class. I can just send you the video of the class. You just see this out of my head sometimes. And then also, if you're interested in learning to dance Lindy Hop from kind of a moderately experienced beginner level up through, so like you can do triple steps, but you don't know much more than that. We have a class that we want to start up for that, but we need a couple more couples to do it. That's probably for this crowd. I'm asking you if you have a roommate or a significant other or something that you wish knew how to dance, so you'd have someone to dance with. We're trying to get those folks caught up so you can keep dancing in the kitchen with a partner too through all this silliness. So let me know if you have those folks in your life. I'm at Lindy Hopping on Instagram. You can message me through there. It's an easy way to find me. And I'll see you all on a dance floor soon, I hope. Thanks, friends. Have fun. Make choices.